The next topic is related to the previous lesson. That is when we talk about the C constructs or the C, how can I say, the C tokens, right? So the next thing that you continue from the lesson two to lesson three will be the variable declaration. So in this lesson, so you know how to use the variables, right? Variable declaration. Okay, so the outline of this lesson will start from the variables and data types, and then I have to classify the data types into integer, floating point, character, right? This is a primitive data type that are very useful in C programming. And we also have to know how to declare a variable, how to initialize them, and then you can know about the user-defined data type. Okay. So first of all, I would like to show you about, to tell you about computer architecture, right? When we're talking about the computer, right? Computer will process data according to the instruction that specified it in a program and produce the output. So what does it mean by the computer? So when we have the computer, right? You have input, right? And then you process and then output, right? When the computer wants to process, right? You have process in the CPU, right? CPU is inside the computer, right? CPU stands for the computer, a central processing unit, right? Now we also have the GPU, right? Graphical processing unit, right? Okay, so this is the main idea of the computer, right? Computer will get the input and then produce output and process output. Okay, CPU will perform such kinds of the arithmetic operation, for example, addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division, and also the logical operation, if else or comparing two numbers. And of course, if we have the CPU with, but we don't have the primary memory, that is not okay, right? Computer, you have to use the what we call the CPU plus RAM, right? You know, RAM, read random access memory, right? When you buy mobile phone or computer, right, the first thing that you need to see is the RAM, right? The RAM of your computer, right? And at this part, right, you will have to store variables, right? Sometimes we can call this is a primary memory or physical memory. I have to say physical memory. Physical memory. Okay, physical memory. We have to store. Remember, we have a variable, right? Variable we store in this word, physical memory or RAM. Okay, and the verb to get the memory from CPU, there is a special word that is a fetch. Fetch means to get data from memory. We call fetch. Okay. At least today you know the word fetch, right? Fetch. So the data and program are stored in RAM of a computer where from it is fetched to fetched by CPU, right? And inside the computer memory, right, only keep the binary digit 0 and 1 only, right? This way, right, information is stored in memory just like we memorize number using digits 0 to 9. Okay, but for computer, right, we just simply use only 0 and 1 on and off, actually 0 or 1, right? On and off, right? Off the light. Because computer only understand on and off, right? Mm-hmm. And for each cell of computer memory has a unique memory address. Okay, this way we have the unique memory address. In order to refer to the value in here, you need to know address, like your house address, right? And what is inside your house will be yourself, your family, your father, mother, yourself, right? But your house is a memory address, right? If you have the like 100/33 is your house address, right? This we call the memory, okay? In order to instruct CPU to process some data located in the memory, we have to specify the address of that location. Specify the address of that location. Okay, it's very difficult for human to remember the memory address. Difficult to memory the memory address. So instead of that, we can use the number in order to declare the location of the address in memory. Instead of using some number to address any memory, we label that location by a variable name. So physically, you can refer to the address of the memory by using the number, but number is too long, right? And it's difficult to remember, right? When you write a program, if you want to recognize or remember every single address, right? When you write a program, it's not fun. So what you have to do is for C programming, you can point or you can refer to that address by using variable name. And you don't have to memorize the location of that variable. You can just simply say that if this is your variable. For example, if you have to remember this one, but you say that this one is Natasha residence. Okay, this is the name. This is my house number, right? So instead of using this, you cannot remember, right? This number, right? But if you refer to it as a Natasha, right? So this is my variable. This is a variable. So it is easier to remember. Okay. Similarly to this case, instead of remember the memory location, you can just name it as a variable. This means using variables, a programmer no more needs to concern about actual location. So you don't have to concern about actual location in memory. Okay, you can just, if you want to use it, you can just refer to it as the variable name to access it. Okay, this is the way that we will use what we call these kinds of things as an abstraction. This concept is abstraction. Abstraction is the way that instead of using the, take this long number, right, as an address, you can just refer to it as the name. Okay? A good example is that. Okay, when I want to refer to Golawit, right? Golawit is a name, right, or king. Right, king, right? So you have the student ID like 65 blah 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 3402, something like this, right? This is wrong and this is difficult to remember or to memorize. And then if I want to refer to you, right, I can just call your name, right? This is Golawit or king, right? So it will refer to your memory address or your student ID. Right, this is longer and more difficult to understand or to remember. Okay, this is an example of abstraction. Abstraction. Okay. And the next topic that you might have to know that is about the CPU, the number of the bits, right? In the past, right, the CPU referred to the CPU 8 bits, right? It will refer to the collection of the, the CPU doesn't access memory by individual bits, right? You have to refer to it as the architecture. For example, for the past in the first time of CPU, right? CPU has only 8 bit, right? So we call 8 bit CPU, and we go to 16 bit CPU and then 30 bit CPU. And nowadays we have 64 bit CPU. What does this mean? It means that if you want to, okay, simply speaking, right? It's just if we have to use integer for calculation, right? Mostly. So 8 bit means the number of the bits that you one integer where you will be kept, okay? Or the architecture, computer architecture, right? When you fetch the from the main memory at a time, right? And but we don't have just only the data type integer, right? We also have the floating point character, right? We have to make different use of how to locate or to access the main memory, right? To further qualify that memory location, we associate the type of the data it contains, which also include with the width of data, right? But C programming language provides you a rich set of data type which is associated with the variables. With variables can be used to label some memory location, specify the type of data it contains and width of that data. In order to make it understandable, I want to say like this. Where is the slide? What I'm trying to say is that if you, in the past, right, if you want to fetch an integer, you can just simply fetch only 8 bits, right? And then to 16 bits and then 32 bits. And nowadays, once you, this 8 bit means 1 byte, 2, 4, and 8, right? So nowadays, it is a 64-bit architecture, computer architecture. So when you want to fetch an integer, right? Sometimes you can use the 4 bytes. Sometimes you can use 8 bytes, right? 4 bytes is 32 bits and 64 bits for 8 bytes, okay? Where 8 bits is, where 1 byte is 8 bits, okay? So and C programming provide you many data type byte, short, in long, right? That I'm going to talk about this soon, right? Right here. So in C programming, right? We want to classify the data type into three classes. The first one is a primitive data type. Second one is the user-defined data type. And the last one is the derived data type. We are not going to talk about the derived data type now, right? Today, we just talk about the primitive data type and user-defined data type. The primitive data type of the integer we have, of the C programming will be integer, character, floating point, and double precision floating point, right? And for the user-defined type, will be type-defined and enumeration, right? We will start from the integer data type. Integer data type we use to specify a variable that contain only integer value, right? Either positive or negative number, right? With a fraction part, right? The keyword of using this is the int, right? And normally we'll use one word in order to store an integer. for the 16-bit machine, right, integer will have the range of the value from minus 32768 to 32767, right, which mean minus 2 raised to the power 15 to 2 raised to the power 15 minus 1. Why minus 1? The reason is why minus 1 is it is the zero value, right, including zero. Okay, so it's until 32767. Why just only 15? If we have 16 bits, but why we have just only 15? Because we need 1 bit, right, for the side bit. Side bit mean positive or negative number. Okay, 15, because the first bit will be reserved for a side bit, right? Plus or minus stand for positive or negative number. Normally when you define like 16 bit, right? The first bit will be reserved to be a side bit. Side bit. Mm-hmm. Okay, this is important. Okay, this is an integer data type, right? If you want to define integer, right? Integer, it is ranging from this one and this one. And also you can write it sided int in order to specify that is the integer, sided integer. You can also define an integer as unsigned integer. It means that it is a positive number all the time. Positive number. So the range will be 0 to 65535, which is 2 less to the power 16 minus 1. Okay. And if you want to declare short int or 8 bit, right, it will start from minus 128 to 127. But for unsigned short integer from 0 to 255. And if you want to have the integer, long integer, 32 bits, it will, the length of the integer will be from this number to this number. And if you want to design unsigned, right, from 0 to this number, okay, this about 4,000 million. Just remember it, because you have to remind yourself that when you define or you declare a data type, you need to know that the range of your number will not exceed than the predefined range. Okay. Okay, this is a table, and this is another table. Mm-hmm. You check it yourself. And the next one, the next data type is floating point, right? Floating point, you have the float of the 32 bits, 4 bytes, and this is 8 bytes, 64 bits, right? The range from this number to this number. Okay, this is a floating point or the real number, if you want to define the real number. And this is the character data type and the range of it, and then the width in bits. Okay, so we are now to the how to write a program, a very simple program without the process, right? Suppose, first of all, you have to declare a variable. If you want to declare a variable, you need to use this syntax. This is a syntax. Starting from data type, right? Data type can be int, byte short, byte int, ไม่ใช่ no character int float double right can be the data type and the variable name you have to name it by yourself so this is some examples of how to declare for variables int x float y in a int abc float def but you can combine that because there are four lines of this declaration so if you want to combine it you can use int x comma abc semicolon float y comma def def log n semicolon okay this is the syntax of the declaration of a variable so this is some examples of the valid and invalid declaration this one in x y z a b c d f this one and this one is valid right float x in y valid character c valid right float x y in x y invalid because a variable cannot be two types x cannot be both float and int no in x y z invalid because in x is are declared two times or twice in 1 2 3 x is invalid right the variable cannot start with the digit okay this is some examples of how to declare the valid and invalid variables this the last but not the last okay initialization of a variable after a variable is declared you must initialize it initialization of a variable means assigning some value to it okay you may have some question that why do we have to declare a value to it I'm going to tell you the reason from the red here it's not the problem that you don't have to initialize it but it is a good manner there's not wrong with that logically but it's a good manner that you have to declare or initialize some value into your declared variable otherwise if you declare it you know that sometimes the computer has run for a long time before you run this program right there's some garbage collection in your memory and once you run your program right the program has not yet start from zero the memory is not clean up to zero all for sure so there are some garbage collection so in order to make the use of your variables correctly you have to initialize it before use okay this is a way that you will there are two ways to initialize your value the first one is when you declare integer x and then you use equal sign and then you assign in just only one line that's possible or second you declare your variable first and then you will initialize later okay you can use in both two forms okay so when we talk about the data type in C, right, we have already talked about the basic or primitive data type in float, double, and character already. And the next thing that I'm going to talk that is a user-defined data type that is enumerate and type-defined. We'll start from type-defined, right? Type-defined will define the existing data type as your name, right? You can use type-defined data type and identifier new name right for example type define integer to be row number this mean row number will be the type of integer for any time you use row number as a data type the user define data type it means that you are going to use integer or integer will be substitute to row number for this example if you use row number student 1 student 2 Does this statement is exactly the same as in you define in student 1 and student 2 semicolon. These two are the same. Exactly the same. So why is the same? Why do we have to do this? Right? You may have a question. One may argue that what for can this be used? The answer is this mechanism is useful for readability of a program. Readability. Readability is important. It means that low number, right? We want to specify that student 1 and student 2 will be low number, okay? It to make the readability of your program. This is the, we are going to use type define or type def later on in the structure. It will be useful in structure and linked list. I'm going to talk about this later, okay? Type define. And the last one is enumerate. As its name, enumerate, enum or enumerate. Enumerate means to make it number. To make it number, right? Enumerate, right? Enumerate is an enumerated data type which can be used to declare variables that have one of the value enclosed with its basis. Right. For example, so you have to start from enum and then name and then basis like this. Okay, I will show you the example for the sake of simplicity. Enumerate, work weekday, right? And define Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Tuesday, Thursday and Friday, right? So when we enumerate this one, you will have a new type. That is weekday. And then you can use Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday as its constant number. And this one will refer to Monday, will have the integer value 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Just in case that you didn't say anything about the value of each element. So for example, if you declare enum weekday like this, I can define weekday today. What does it mean? What is today? What is the day of today? So I can write today is Monday like this. So readability, right? We use enum and type def for increase the readability of your program, right? So when you write like this, like today, you define today as a weekday, right? And what is today? Monday. You can see that. But if you think that Monday is not zero for your intuitive thinking, right? So you can set up Monday to be one by writing like this. Once you write Monday is equal, is initialized to, this one is initialized. Initialize to 1, right? So Tuesday will be automatically changed to 2, 3, 4, and 5. But if you define this one by default, by default, Monday will be 0, 1, 2, and so on, 3, and 4. Okay. That's all. That's all of today class, right? Sorry, now it's 12:30. Okay, there's a question from the chat box, right? If you want to find my video, right? You can go to YouTube. My YouTube is my name, right? Natasha. CPE-KMUTT. You can go to, I'm not sure, to the list, right? How can I call? Can you send a lecture files? Yes, I will send this one. I will send this one to my group. CPE 100. It is in the list เขาเรียกว่าอะไรนะลืม